Republicans are confident that President Trump in 2020 can pick up support from more black voters and that this overwhelmingly Democratic bloc could even provide Trump the winning edge in key swing states. President Trump said he's fine with the Justice Department releasing Special Counsel Robert Mueller's final report without the White House having a chance to examine it first, according to CNN. Lindsey Graham. Andrew Yang, the 44-year-old New York tech entrepreneur running for the 2020 Democratic nomination, has one distinction he might want to lose: he is the preferred presidential candidate of white nationalists. The Chicago Fraternal Order of Police renewed its calls for an investigation into Cook County State's attorney Kim Fox's interference in the charges against Jussie Smollett. George Conway, counselor to the president Kellyanne Conway's husband, said that special counsel Robert Mueller wrote his report the way he did to allow Congress and the American people to decide what to make of the facts. Sean Hannity mocked actor Alec Baldwin's guest stint as a call-in radio host a day after the star took a shot at the Fox News host in a tweet. Zen. Bernie Sanders, EVT, who is running for president and has greatly influenced Democrats' policy positions, said Tuesday that he does not support a bill introduced by House leaders to expand Obamacare. Former FBI Director James Comey said that he's confused by Special Counsel Robert Mueller's report on the Russia investigation. Bristol Palin and her ex-husband posted a photograph together where the daughter of the former governor of Alaska was wearing a world's greatest ex-wife T-shirt. Pete Buttigieg isn't a middle child, but he kind of seems like one. The South Bend, END, mayor and presidential hopeful is soft-spoken, underrated, and conciliatory. If there's anyone who knows how to bridge the gap between two sides, it might be him. Jussie Smollett's employers released a statement of support for the appear actor after prosecutors dropped all charges against him. Former Vice President Joe Biden said he wishes he could have done something during Anita Hill's hearing when SHE accused the Supreme Court nominee Clarence Thomas of sexual harassment. President Trump tapped Air Force Gen John Raymond on Tuesday to head the U.S. Space Command that Trump authorized the creation of last year. Devin Nunes, R. Califf, predicted Tuesday he will likely make criminal referrals as part of an investigation into alleged political bias in the FBI and Justice Department by the end of next week. Rudy Giuliani, one of President Trump's personal attorneys, said that he would have no problem with releasing Trump's written testimony to Special Counsel Robert Mueller. Senate Banking Committee Chairman Mike Capo, R. Idaho, warned the nation's largest banks Tuesday against cutting off access to gun manufacturers and other controversial industries due to political pressure.